Welcome back. If you have been following along, you already know how Quantently can boost your workflow with simple, powerful templating features and a streamlined drag and drop approach. In this part, we're stepping things up. We'll explore how to work with image templates, unlock the power of a smart overflow, and finally put an end to the pain of manually filling out tables and lists. Plus, I'll show you how to use image compression in Quantently to keep your files efficient without sacrificing any quality. In the next and last part of the Quantently tutorial series, we will dive deeper into the more exciting features like smart copywriting, AI design feedback, and ideation support, as well as image generation. If you haven't already opened the Quantently Playground yet, now's the best time. The link is still in the description below. I'm Dave, and I'm your host for today. Let's jump in. After creating our first text template, let's go to the next slide. In the next slide, we try to focus on image templates. So therefore, if you select the first frame in the image template, let's select the whole frame, you'll see a list rendered in Quantently, which renders you a lot of different groups, which is not what we want, as we want to have all of them in one template. Therefore, we can click on the group by option on the top right corner of Quantently and select a group by element type only, which will regroup everything based on the element type, in this case, images. Before we save our image template, we can easily change it. Let's say I would like to have this Naruto-like figure on top and close to it, I think, Luffy looks rather nice. Let's mix a little bit more. What I do here right now is some simple drag and drop action to prepare the template so that we can save it. Looks nice. Let's save it as ice cream template to save. And now we have saved our first image template, which will be rendered also directly in Quantently. What is important, Quantently doesn't have an internet connection. So there's no external server where we save the images. What Quantently tries to do instead, some template frames in your Figma file under document assets. In document assets, you will see all the image templates, which means also that you can have custom image templates based on the file. If you have a newer file and want to bring your image templates with you, you can easily just copy paste them and put it into the new Figma file. Quantently will also realize and recognize if you changed something here to make it really easy to handle your image templates and to ensure that you can use the image template that fits best to your voice or tonality, to your brand, which makes using image templates really easy. Now, after finishing creating our first image template, let's go to the next slide to learn a little bit about the drag and drop functionalities of Quantently, which makes working with content in Quantently and Figma in general way more enjoyable. Therefore, let's select all the components on the screen. What you see here right now is that we have a different avatars, which is a typical use case in Figma. And we probably just realized now that the names are mixed up, which means we have a male image with a female name, which isn't as ideal. Normally in Figma, you would go to each of the individual elements to select them, copy paste, delete, copy paste, delete, remove, move, which is a really tedious and annoying process and costs you a lot of precious time. With Quantently, it's way easier thanks to the drag and drop functionality. You can click in Quantently on an image, drag and drop it above another image, and done. So things that will probably need at least 5 minutes or so are now done in less than a second. It works for sure not only for images, it also works for text. So instead of just moving the images around, you could also move the text around to make the switch easy. And to make it a little bit more chaotic, let's use a randomize mode.
Yay.
Lovely how quick you can fill a content layout with it. Congratulations to you mastering the drag and drop functionality of Contently. Let's go to the next slide, which is a common use case for most of us designers, especially when you use on digital experience platforms like I do a lot, which is creating tables. Creating tables is already annoying enough in Figma, but filling them with life, making them more vivid and tangible, is painful. Straight out painful. With Contently, we try to make it a little bit easier. So normally when you want to add some life to this table, you will need to go to each of the columns and type in something meaningful. Coming up with ideas with content is already stressful. With Contently, you could either use AI, which we will use later, or you could use the templates. So in this example, I created already some templates which will be added to the table when I click the template button, like you can see here now. And right now we've already a table which looks more vivid and more real without doing anything. We could also go straight to the numbers of the table. Let's say group by layer name, like we've learned. And now search for the number column. Here we have it. And as it is numbers, Contently has a nice feature to randomize numbers and keep the related text elements untouched. Which means in case of our lovely table, we have this 5%, 1% tenancy column. And if we click the randomizer for the numbers, it will only randomize the numbers in range based on the number. Which means if you have a bigger number, the randomization will be bigger. If you have smaller numbers, percentages, or something like that, Contently will recognize it and adjust the content accordingly. Click without manipulating the also included other text elements and characters. Let's continue with one of the favorite features of mine, which is the intelligent overflow. This one is a really, really cool feature. Let's select something like those lines here. Try to select all of them. Copy paste and then select the line 01 element on top. Go to Contently, select the line 01. As you would like to edit it, paste the content, and what you will see right away is that Contently tries to use the intelligent overflow feature, which will expand the element to the related direction based on the elements you added to it. This one sounds probably more complicated than it should be. Let's make it a little bit more tangible by going to components, for example. I also realized that this is probably not the best example for what you would do in your daily. Therefore, let's do something different. Let's go to the template slide. Copy paste all the names from the templates. Let's copy it. Copy it all of them. And I prepared a small list page, which is just one card. Could be more. Looks a little bit boring. And now let's element two by layer name, so that we have the names for the different text elements separated in different groups. Go to the name group and paste your template, and instantly Quantently created more, well, way more list elements based on your clipboard, which is rather handy in daily use. And if you think it still looks too boring, you can also use the randomizer to make it a little bit more vivid. One handy feature of Quantently is also the image compression. When you have a lot of images in Figma, it could potentially slow down your whole device, your whole computer. And Quantently tries to solve it somehow, especially if you want to work with a lot of image templates. Therefore, we have built an image compression. Click on the Quantently plugin, select an image layer, like this one. And from here on, you have two options. You could either click the image compression directly in the group, which will compress all the images in the group, based on a percentage, which is nice. But you could also go directly on the context menu, click compress images, and here you have a little bit more control about the compression rate, which means in our case, we know that we probably don't need to have images so this big. I guess an hour for just to for presentation reasons. Never do it at this rate. We can use 0.01 megabit as a target. I guess most of you already realized it if you have a bigger files that they tend to get quite messy and slow. In some cases, you even get this error message on the left in Figma, which hints you about your file size. And with the Quantently image compression, you can tackle this specific problem to make everything a little bit more fluffy and snappy. Okay, image compression is active, and we have also set the max size to 0.01. You're fine with your settings. You can click the compress image button. Then you will see here the percentage going up, and if it's done, it gives you a nice summary about what happens and about the amount of space you've saved up. That's it for this part. We've seen how Quantently handles image templates, smart overflow, and how it can seriously ease the pain of working with tables, lists, and a huge amount of data to make your layouts a little bit more lifelike and less painful, so that you can focus more on the design part. Plus, that image compression, super handy, huh? But we are not done yet. In the final part of the series, we are diving into the exciting world of AI. From smart copywriting to AI-powered design feedback and ideation support, and even image generation, right aside in Quantently. I'm Dave, and I'm happy to see you next time. Don't forget to subscribe and stay tuned. See you.